We essentially have two groups of sites that we offer for access. The first are field sites, and the second are more lab-based. And the basic and most fundamental take-home message I want everybody to know is that you can apply for access to these sites, and it's for free. If you are awarded a visit, all your costs are covered. And that's something that still many people don't appreciate and still don't believe. But in fact, we cover travel to visit a site, and then the accommodation when you're there, and all the field costs in the field, and all the analytical costs if you're working in a lab. So the field sites, we decided that with the forthcoming JUICE mission and the interest in all the icy moons, etc., we should certainly expand our capabilities to look at icy terrains. So in the current round, we have access to go to sites in Greenland and Iceland, where you can go and work on the glacial environments if you wish, or the tundra type conditions. The plan is in the near future, we're going to augment the sites, and we're actually going to add the high Puna Plateau in Argentina is also going to come into the RI. And so it should be possible also to go and study glacial environments and maybe the extreme saline lakes of Argentina. The other sites that are included in the field site, obviously the hydrothermal sites, anything on Iceland is possible. So the hydrothermal sites there, the Dalol Depression in Ethiopia, where we have, again, extreme temperature conditions, some of the hottest places on Earth. There's some very, I will use the word extreme far too often, because clearly we picked sites that we think are potential analogues for other planetary environments. And that usually means very extreme terrestrial environments. So the saline lakes, but particularly the hydrothermal systems in the Afar region of Ethiopia are very extreme. Then we have the Rio Tinto River in Spain, which has a pH of about just over one. So there we have a whole environment which is extremely acidic, and that's an area we work on. And another new site which has been added is the Botswana and saline lakes, where we have the largest area of extent of saline lakes on the planet are in northern Botswana, and you can get access to that area as well. So those are the field sites, and typically we would fund people to go and visit these sites, and they're supported by local scientists who will show you around and advise you where to take the optimal samples, depending on what you wish to work on. And visits of a week to 2 weeks are funded by Europlanet. And in addition to that, we have 24 labs. We cover some things that are simulation. So there are labs which are actually simulating icy conditions, so you can do experiments under extreme pressures and temperatures, but equally you can also do analysis under these conditions. One of the things we really try and do is to encourage the development of equipment. One of the things that is very popular with particularly some of the field sites is actually testing equipment that might be scheduled to go on a mission, or prototypes to assess how they will operate under extreme temperatures or dusty conditions and things like that. The lab facilities cover things from analog, actually doing experiments and physically testing things, to actual analyses or doing measurements under extreme conditions, looking at spectral characteristics, looking at high temperature spectroscopy or low temperature down to about minus 200. So we have a very, very large spectrum of capabilities. And I obviously encourage you to have a look at the Europlanet site, because there's a direct link to the RI, and you can see much more details about the different capabilities that we have. Anybody in the world can apply, because up to 20% of the access is allowed for internationalization. The commission is pushing at the moment. So we have had applicants come from Israel, South America, South Africa, Japan, just a few that come to my mind. Any person from an academic to even technical staff, there's no reason why people can't be examining technical aspects of their instrumentation work, and they want to check or develop things under higher temperature or lower pressures. And so those sort of experiments can be conducted. Even master's students are encouraged to apply. If you have support and can write a good proposal, then there's no reason you can't get funding. And an important thing to stress there is that all the applications have to be anonymous. So well-known professors don't have any more chance of being funded than up-and-coming junior staff or junior PhDs.